Film composition refers to how characters and objects are placed on the screen. A central guideline of film composition is the rule of thirds. The rule of thirds breaks the frame into three vertical sections, left, center, and right, and three horizontal sections, top, middle, and bottom. Cinematographers use this grid to determine the best placement of subjects within the frame. For example, characters tend to be placed on or near the two vertical lines, with important subject matter typically placed at or near one of the four intersections. The top horizontal line is often used to place character eyes. In these examples, notice how characters are aligned with the grid and how one or more of the most important elements of the shot are on or near one of the four intersections. The grid breaks up the frame and helps cinematographers make artistic decisions about the placement of subjects. So far, we have looked at how the rule of thirds is used in two dimensions, with the vertical, left, center, right, and the horizontal, top, middle, bottom. But there is an important third dimension, depth. There are three levels of depth: foreground, middle ground, and background. Subjects placed in the foreground tend to have more weight and narrative significance than subjects in the middle ground or the background. For example, in this shot, Charles Kane dominates the foreground at a moment of power when firing his best friend Jebediah, who happens to be in the middle ground, with the powerless Mr. Bernstein helplessly observing from the background. But watch how depth is used in this scene from later in the film, when Kane loses his power and files for bankruptcy.
With respect to the said newspapers, the said Charles Foster Kane hereby relinquishes all control thereof, and of the syndicates pertaining thereto, and any and all other newspaper, press, and publishing properties of any kind whatsoever, and agrees to abandon all claim
thereto. Which means we're bust, all right.
Well, out of cash.
All right, Mr. Bernstein. I've read it, Mr. Thatcher. Let me sign it, and I'll go home.
Too old to call me Mr. Thatcher, Charles.
You're too old to be called anything else. You were always too old.
Now it is the bankruptcy papers and Mr. Bernstein that dominate the foreground, while Kane moves to the background. In this scene, the framing suggests that the bankruptcy papers hold more narrative significance than the once powerful Kane. In this next example, notice how subject placement follows the rule of thirds, and depth places Theo pouring a drink in the foreground, Jasper telling a story in the middle ground, and Key flipping through photos in the background. Let's watch the short scene and analyze how it uses composition afterward.
Yeah, there you go. Julian and Theo met among a million protesters in a rally by chance. But they were there because of what they believed in the first place, their faith. They wanted to change the world, and their faith kept them together. But by chance, Dylan was born.
This is him?
Yeah, that's him. He'd have been about your age, magical child. Beautiful. Their faith put in praxis.
Praxis is what happened.
Chance. It was their sweet little dream. He had little hands, little legs, little feet, little lungs. In 2008, along came the flu pandemic. And then by chance, he was gone.
Oh, Jesus.
You see, Theo's faith lost out to chance. So, why bother if life's going to make its own choices?
If we overlay the rule of thirds grid, you will notice that it is Theo's face that is on one of the important intersections. Further, by placing Theo in the foreground, he is given narrative significance. The composition in this scene communicates that it is Theo's reaction to Jasper's story that is important. It is important we hear the story, but our eyes are drawn to Theo as we experience the sad story through his pain. So far, the examples we have seen have had a relatively static composition, meaning once subjects are placed, they do not really change position. The one exception is when Charles Kane changed composition by walking from the foreground to the background. Within a scene, composition can change by either moving the subject or by moving the camera. Take a look at this final example and notice how often the composition changes, sometimes by moving characters, but more often by moving the camera.
Work with the Tesseract is what drew Loki to it, and his allies. It is a signal to all the realms that the Earth is ready for a higher form of war.
A higher form?
You forced our hand. We had to come up with
something. A nuclear deterrent, because that always calms everything right down.
Remind me again how you made your fortune, Stark?
I'm sure if he still made weapons, Stark would be neck deep.
Wait, hold on. How is this now about me?
I'm sorry, isn't everything?
I thought humans were more evolved than this.
Excuse me, did we come to your planet and blow stuff
you
up?
You understand
your champions
right?
Such
you're
mistrust.
Not my champion.
Are you boys really that naive? Shield
so
monitors potential threats.
Captain America's on threat watch.
He's
not your concern, Doctor.
You're on that list?
Shoot, let me
are you above or below
Avengers? Stark's a guy.
I feel threatened.
Show some respect. If I need to put you down, then I will.
Oh, yeah, man.
So much is being communicated through composition in this scene. During the argument, each character is brought to or toward the foreground when they speak. And take a moment to pause the video and analyze this final shot. You should notice that Loki's staff has been moved to the foreground. The shaft of the staff is aligned with the top line of the Rule of Thirds grid, with the Tesseract Stone near one of the four intersections. The Avengers have been pushed back to the middle ground, and their eye lines now align with the bottom of the grid. The composition is communicating that it is Loki, the owner of the staff, who has the power. He is the one who is causing the argument and turning the Avengers upside down. Hopefully you have a better understanding of how cinematographers use the Rule of Thirds to strategically place subjects within the frame, and how they use depth to highlight subjects within that frame to create narrative significance. Of course, cinematography is an art, and in art, all rules are made to be broken. But now that you know the basics of composition, it is something you will notice in every film you watch. If you have fun examples of movie scenes that use composition in creative ways, share them by posting in the comments below.